When we are united in Christ, we are all in it together. Today's gospel is beautiful and rich and affirming for those who are united in Christ. Today's gospel is beautiful and rich and challenging for those who like to pass judgment, for those who are consumed by their own ego, and for those who think they are better than other people. You're familiar with a beautiful story, a beautiful passage. And a woman with great love comes and shows outlandish love to Jesus. And the Pharisee, the host of this event, can only see her past. And he judges her and does not even recognize her by name, just says, "The sinner has entered my house." Jesus welcomes her great love and lets her know that her sins are forgiven and she is sent to go in peace. If we were to do a little bit of in-depth study of this passage, we realize that the host, the Pharisee himself, has sinned by not offering Jesus proper hospitality and proper welcome into the home. The Pharisee, in his own broken ego, cannot see beyond the woman's past. All you do is see who she used to be. But we know that in Christ Jesus, we have a deep hope and a deep future when we turn back to the Lord and we move forward with Him in faith and in peace and in celebration and community. The words of Jesus to the woman are words that each and every one of us take to heart in our own lives, that our faith has saved us. As we come together this day, united in Christ, let us think about the importance of the faith that we share, the faith that we continue to share and express in this community, and the difference that faith makes in our lives, our relationship with Jesus Christ, who calls us from our sins, from our past, to a life of service, a life of kindness, and a life of extravagant love. Perhaps we might even want to pray and meditate, "Lord, how can I, in my faith with you, show a similar type of extravagant love like the woman in the gospel who came and you sent forth in peace, letting her know that her faith is saved?" Many of you are aware that Father Edmund is visiting his mom and dad down in Haiti, and when I was conscious of that, I was grateful that Father Jack was able to come and join us at this Mass. We could introduce him and he could receive a very warm welcome. I think in Polish it's Vitami. My Polish is not so good, but he can teach me and teach the community. And I was thinking about, it's the final weekend that I get to preach at all Masses. Pray with all of the community that gathers last night, the three Masses today, and share a common message and a common belief off of the scriptures of the day. So I was praying and meditating, reflecting, how can I summarize 8 years of ministry here in this community? So I was praying and reflecting, and thinking, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to wrap it up. I probably won't do that good of a job, but I'm going to do the best that I can as I have in several other Masses. So I was at a gathering the other day, and one of the parishioners said, "So Father Mike, what's your favorite memory? What's the favorite moment that you've had here and into Jesus of Pride?" I'm not sure often you've seen me with a deer in the headlights, like, okay, I'm on the spot, how in the heck can I even answer that? A buddy of mine, John Alford, gave me a quick elbow. "Mike, just say the five of us that are with you, then you're off the hook." But John was much quicker in response than I was. So I thought, reflected, I was like, how can I summarize the entire time that I've been here in one moment? Now, we're very shy, DRE, at call. "So Father Mike, it had to be the moment you hired me 6 years ago." "Well, Pat, let me see. I still can't summarize my entire time, even in welcoming you and hiring you." So I prayed and reflected, and many of you know the wonderful Pat Carey, Pat Bernardi, who happens to be sitting in the back of church with her husband this morning. I asked her to help me because she's made me look good since she's been on staff here with me, and she started doing some calculating. Pat, you might know who schedules ministers, schedules masses when you want a mass set for loved ones, puts together the bulletin in a beautiful fashion, a hardworking administrative assistant extraordinaire. So she looked at numbers of what we have done, united in Christ Jesus. And I have to trust the numbers that she gave. So Pat said that united in Christ, this community has welcomed over 450 children to the altar to share their first communion as one of many joyous steps for them united to Christ as they grow in faith. Pat told me that I have witnessed the exchange of vows of over 50 couples. I think she included the couple I married yesterday, as well as the one in 2 weeks, and I'm not sure if she counted the one in October or the one in July. Pat let me know that I had the opportunity to unite in Christ over 200 children, including a very precious child that I'll be baptizing shortly after this mass. Don't worry if you think I'm going on long and long for the homily. It's not going to be that long. And united in Christ. In this community, we have supported and lifted up to God over 130 families who lost a loved one to death. United in Christ, we have celebrated, we have prayed, we have been fed, we have turned to the Lord in so many different occasions, in so many different times. So how can I possibly focus in on one moment or one event of which we have been privileged to share over the time since I arrived here in 2008? So I was thinking, I listed four sacramental moments that we have been united in Christ. Family and friends gathered together. It doesn't count the number of times that I've been fortunate to pray and offer the sacrament of healing, of anointing to people, and the many other events. We know that there have been ministerial moments that we have come together, united in Christ, where we recognize that we're blessed and gifted people, and so what we give back to God in stewardship and in capital campaigns is just part of who we are as a faith community. We know that united in Christ, caring for those in need, in our own lives, in our community, through the PADS program, to respond now, even caring for kids at the school where Father Evans from in Haiti, it's just part of who we are, united in Christ. So ministerially, there have been numerous moments, united in Christ, where we have come together because we are a faithful people, because God has blessed us, and because God has strengthened us. So it is impossible for me to reflect on a moment, a period of time, where extravagant love of this community has been poured forth for one another and men, women, and families beyond the boundaries of this parish. When we hear the gospel of the man, the Pharisee, calling the woman the sinner, she steps and washes the feet of Jesus with her tears. What other example do we have in scriptures of extravagant love of someone washing feet? Now that's an example of Jesus at Holy Thursday at the Last Supper, which inspires us to generosity and extravagant love to one another as well. So Jack and I have been talking, chatting, all sorts of stuff. He's been busy in Orland, I've been busy here, trying to make sure that we can properly say goodbye to our respective communities. They will stop by here last month for a whirlwind day of activity and ministry. And after that day, I was talking to some parishioners. Jack, this is how one of the parishioners reflected on me and you. He said, you know, when you shake Father Mike's hand, his hand gets lost in yours. You know, it's grabbing on the golf club or what it is, but I guess that's the truth with my friend. He said, when you shake Father Jack's hand, his hand gets lost in yours. So I thought about the words of that parishioner, and I realized that Father Jack is in incredibly good hands when he is in your hands. He will come to know what I know and carry in my heart about your goodness, your service, your kindness, the way that you serve extravagantly because of your faith in Jesus. My prayer, Jack, is that you come to know how blessed you are to be in the hands of this community of faith that will welcome you. They will challenge you, but they're going to serve you and serve with you, and they're going to praise God because of their faith in Christ Jesus our Lord. We are here today welcoming Jack, sharing in the Eucharist, and reflecting on what it means to bring the gospel to life in each and every one of our own lives. I invite us to reflect on the final words of Jesus to the woman whose rich future was centered on her life in Jesus. He said, "Your faith has saved you." Today, let's reflect on the gift of faith that we've been privileged to share here. If it's a month, if it's approaching 8 years, if it's a lifetime, or some other amount of time within which you've been calling into Jesus and drawing your home. United in Christ, it makes all the difference in our lives and in the world. United in Christ, we know the gift and the power of faith. May that faith continue to blossom in our lives. May we continue to grow through word and sacrament. United in Christ, as God's name.